Hello and welcome to Miranda's Magic Cardigan Free Workshop for your circular knitting machine. I'm going to demonstrate to you in this free workshop how you can knit all sizes of cardigans with your circular knitting machine in every size.
For this workshop I've been using my circular knitting machine, of course. You can use whatever circular knitting machine you have. I've used my yarn needle, a pair of scissors, a few stitch markers. You can also use a few pieces of yarn. I've been using a crochet hook, 5.5 millimeters. You can also use 6 millimeters or 5 or whatever you like. You only use it to close the edges of your tubes. I'm going to demonstrate how to do that, so that's not a problem if you don't know how to do that. And I have used about 15 cakes. That's 1.5 kilo. We are in Europe, so we are talking in grams and kilos. It's yarn for a needle 4 to 5 millimeters. It's yarn that fits your machine, of course. But I've used about 15 cakes of yarn. And we need, of course, our pattern. I have to explain a few things about the pattern. This is a pattern that's made with a big circular knitting machine. If you don't have a big circular knitting machine, that's not a problem. Every tube you can divide into 2 tubes of 22 stitches. That will create together a tube that's like this. So when you only have a small circular knitting machine with 22 needles, instead of 1 tube of 150 rows, you knit 2 tubes of 150 rows and you join them. I will demonstrate everything in the video. So this is based on 46 or 48 needle machines or 44 needles and even 40 needle machines that will always fit. But when you only have a 22 needle machine, you have to double up all these tubes. So, and now I'm going to explain. Make a print screen, because you need it. This is for the cardigan with the 3 colors and the sleeves matching the stripes. Okay, the black numbers are the amount of rows. Don't start knitting because you have to cast on and cast off in a special way to make it easier, but this is only explaining the pattern. This is the sleeve. The sleeves have 3 stripes. And this is your front panel, the sleeve. This is the sleeve. This is your back part and this is your sleeve. I'm going to demonstrate everything step by step. And these are the panels that are the length of your cardigan. So I have to knit for the front of my sleeves and the front of my cardigan a tube with 150 rows for the left and a tube with 150 rows for the right. And I made color changes so they will match with the with the colors I made with these tubes. So I've knitted 32 rows in color. This one, see, with the three axes. I've knitted 34 rows with this color, and I've knitted 34 rows with this color. I've knitted 50 rows with this color, and again I did that also for the other sleeves, left, right. And this is also left, the back part, and right. So 34 rows, 140 rows, 34, 34, 32. And these panels are just one color and 240 rows. And when you want to add sleeve pockets, you have to knit 80 rows per pocket. And you have to knit it in the color of the tube where it's gonna be behind, so it's going to be invisible. So when you want to add it at this color, you have to knit in that color 2 times 80 rows. But it will be clear when we are going to start. So The pattern for the baby cardigan is attached at the end of the video, so, and also the pattern will be demonstrated there. Let's continue.
First, I'm going to demonstrate a very simple technique for casting on and casting off with scrap yarn. This is a very quick tutorial I've added into this video because it's very useful for every project you ever want to make with use of scrap yarn. So let's continue.
Hello and welcome to this quick scrap yarn workshop. In this workshop, I'm going to demonstrate to you how you can add and remove your scrap yarn in 1 second and can reuse it over and over. First, I'm going to start to knit with my scrap yarn a couple of rows. And then I'm going to change to another color of scrap yarn. I'm just cutting my yarn, putting it to the inside between the last and the first needle. And then I take another piece of scrap yarn and put it into my feeder, also between the last and the first needle. Make sure that the tails are long enough to reach the table. And knit one round, so every single needle has to pick the color once. I'm cutting my yarn and putting my tail between the last and the first needle, as every tail I have used. And then I'm taking my working yarn. I'm hanging a long piece of thread inside my machine because I'm going to use it to pick up my stitches and do whatever I want to do with them. I'm going to demonstrate to you how I like to close my tube. But first, you have to put your yarn between the last and the first needle. And then you are going to knit. So what have we done? We have started with scrap yarn, changed to another color and knit one round with scrap yarn. And now I'm just knitting my desired pattern. That's not interesting because that's for a special project. And now I'm finished. I'm cutting my yarn a long piece because I want to use it to close my tube. I'm taking it out of the feeder between the last and the first needle again. And then I'm going to put my scrap yarn into my feeder between the last and the first needle, and I'm going to knit one round. See, just the same place all the time between the last and the first needle. One round, so every needle just picks the yellow color in this case one time. I'm taking it out of the feeder and I'm taking another piece of scrap yarn. And I'm going to knit a couple of rounds with the scrap yarn. And after knitting a couple of rounds, there are no rules. I'm just cutting my yarn and knitting until my work drops from the machine. So I'm continue cranking when my yarn runs out until my project comes loose. Now I'm going to demonstrate how I'm going to close the tube. I'm using my crochet hook. I'm using 5.5 millimeter, but some people like to use thicker or thinner needle. It doesn't matter. It's what you like and that what fits your work. So I have knitted my work. I'm stretching it. And now I have both ends with scrap yarn. This is why I changed my color. I'm going to take out all of the ends, and I'm looking for the working yarns. They are a bit tangled because I took a little bit too long ends, but better safe than sorry. And now you can easily recognize your stitches. You have to look at the stitches in the color of your working yarn between the scrap yarn pieces. And there are 22 stitches, or 46 or 48 in the round. And I'm going to close them by pairs. So on the right, I have all those tails. And now I'm going to find my last and first stitch. You can easily recognize them because we have the pieces of yarn hanging at the end, the first and the last stitch. This is my first stitch. I'm poking my needle in from the outside to the inside, and then I'm going to find the last stitch where the working yarn is coming out from, and I'm poking in from in to outside. That's my first pair. In total, I have to connect 11 pairs. So that's easy to see. And when I'm done, I can remove my scrap yarn in a second. I'm finding my working yarn, and I'm going to pull through the yarn through both loops. And then I'm going to pick up the next pair and pulling the yarn through all loops on my hook. I do that for all the 11 pairs. Keep counting them so you won't miss anything. I speed up my video because this is not where the workshop is for. But you can see me doing this in many workshops that are coming up. So I already have about 60 different project and instruction videos. You can find them in my Circular Knitting Machine playlist on my channel. When I have to find my last pair, I just poke them out a little bit. And now it's finished. My tube is closed. I'm making a single stitch. And now I'm ready to remove my scrap yarn. We knitted with the yellow, or I knitted with the yellow one round. And I'm just going to pick up that lonely piece of yarn. And I'm pulling just at that one single strand, and this is where the magic happens. You can just pull it out of your work and you can reuse it, and then you can take off the big piece of scrap yarn. You can just reuse it, and my tube is closed. I will demonstrate it again for the other side of this tube, but first I'm going to stick in my yarn end. So finished. At the other end, it's exactly the same. Make sure that all the pieces of yarn are on the outside and untangled. Find yourself the first pair. It's where the scrap yarn starts and begins. I took a real long piece. So find your two stitches. You can easily find them because we have the pieces of yarn going through. This is my working end, this is my last knitted stitch, and this is my first stitch. So I'm picking those two stitches up, and I'm going to close the tube. This is my first pair, and the next 10 pairs I have to do the same. I will speed up again. And I'm almost finished, so I'm going to find my last and 11th pair of stitches to close. And then the fun part comes again of removing the scrap or waste yarn. Very quick and ready to reuse. I'm going to pull out that one piece of strand. And there is the rest, and it's finished. And that simple is it to use scrap yarn and remove it and don't throw it away.
So start knitting tubes following your pattern and close them up at the ends. If you want to have pockets, I've knitted my pockets 80 rows and close them up also, and then you are prepared to start joining all those tubes into a cardigan. We start joining our tubes with the shoulder parts and the sleeves.
Starting at the end, picking up a stitch. And then continuing, going in where you came out, going in where you came out, picking up two bars at a time, and only where the color is changing, I'm picking up one bar at a time, so I can make the color change go flawless.
Join all three panels to each other until they look like this, and then we continue closing our sleeves.
Now I have joined my tubes for the back and the front with the shoulder. So we have the extreme long part. And now we are going to close the sleeves by just folding the tube over. And we are going to close the 1, 2, 3, the first 100 rounds. So I'm going to mark the place where I have to stop. And of course, also the opposite sleeve, so I don't forget to stop. And then I'm just going to join them as we did before. Starting at the end, picking up a stitch, and then continuing, going in where you came out, going in where you came out, picking up two bars at a time, and only where the color is changing, I'm picking up one bar at a time, so I can make the color change go flawless. So do this for both sleeves, but don't forget to leave this open. And then I see you back when you have closed both sleeves.
Then your work will look like this. And then we are going to add the next tube for the length.
After closing the sleeves, you have this. This is basically the back, and this is basically the front of your cardigan. And what we have to do now is we are going to join the panel from here all the way around to here, the tube, I mean. So I'm just going to start with joining my long panel to this short piece. This is the sleeve, so I'm going to join this. Just simple as we did before. Picking up a bar. And on the
other part also. As you can see, I'm almost done. I'm going to go as far as I can. Those tails are going to finish off after joining everything. And just continue going around the corner. And keep on joining your tube. You're joining your tube on the back now. You cannot go wrong because there's only just one possibility. Follow the tracks and continue all along the back, and then I will see you when I'm at the next corner, armpit, I don't know how you call this piece, under your arm in English. Now I'm going just to continue this last piece. Just follow the same tracks you did all the way. Almost done, almost done. Pimmetje, pimmetje, pimmetje. One moment, please. One moment. Almost done. I can smuggle a little bit when I don't have even rows. Pimmetje, please. One moment. It's almost done. I'm almost finished, boy. I'm almost finished. Wait a moment. Please wait. Wait, wait, wait. Please, one moment. I cannot retape this. Please. And now, my cardigan is going to look like a cardigan. And I'm going to join my next tubes. This is a sleeve, and this is a sleeve, and I just have to add next panels, just the way we did, and I see you back when I'm going to add the pockets in between two tubes while joining the tubes. So don't continue joining tubes without watching the next part of the video when you want to add your pockets. Okay, I have to give my little boy here some attention. Okay, let's go to the next step, adding the pockets to our cardigan. Now I'm going to join my next tube, but I'm also going to join my pockets. And how am I going to do that? I have made some numbers to make clear how to join them. You're going to add number one to number one. And number two to number two. I'm going to demonstrate how to do that. So, and I'm going to join number three to number three. And I'm going to join number four to number four. So Now my preparation is ready for joining. First, we are going to connect the front side of our pocket to the front side of our panel. So make sure that you put your pocket in between, doubled up, and then you're going to connect number one to number one. I have to turn it so that the pocket is facing toward me. And what are we going to do? I'm going to use the vertical bars of my long panel, and I'm going to use the V's of my pocket. This is the V. This is not a V, this is the A. I'm going to use the V's. But first we have to start finding our point. So make sure that you have number one and number one on each other. And then you are going to find your track, and you have to find your 15th bar. You don't have to be exactly with the first one, but you have to count your bars until you found your 15th bar. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So this is my 15th bar. Okay. I'm going to use a stitch marker so I won't lose it. Okay, we are going to start joining our pocket at the 15th bar. So it's not on the edge and it's not on the side. I have a piece of yarn. It's not supposed to be very long because we are only going to join this piece. So, I've marked my 15th bar, and what are we going to do now? We are going to use the V of the pocket. There are 23 in this pocket because I have a 46 needle machine. I'm going to use that V, not the A, but the V. I'm pulling my yarn through, and then I'm taking out that marker, and I'm putting my needle under that one bar. Okay, and now I'm going to continue by picking up every V, and the second one I'm using two bars to connect, and then I'm alternating between one bar and two bar for every V. So this is one bar, and the next V is two bars. Stay on track and join them all the way, alternating one bar and two bars until you have connect this side of your pocket all the way. You can pull your yarn and then it will close seamless. It seems that I lost track somewhere. I just cheat a little bit, smuggle. I don't mind. And when you're done, you just pull your yarn and the inside, this part of your pocket is connected. Just leave the yarn. We are working that later. So this one is okay. Now we are going to join this piece. So I'm taking another piece of yarn. And I'm basically going to do exactly the same. I'm going to find me my 15th bar. 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. This should be my 15th bar, about. I put my stitch marker in, so I know where to start. And then I'm going to join number 3 to number 3. Also, the part that's on the outside of your tube. And I'm going to do exactly the same. I want to do it also this way. So I have to count myself 34 bars. 34. This is my 34th stitch. So now I'm joining 3 to 3. The numbers are facing the other side. And I just find my first V. And start joining one bar. Oh, where's my from? One bar. Next V. Two bars. Third V. One bar. Second V. Two bars. Stay on track. Fifth V. One bar. Sixth. Two bars. Seventh. And continue all the way. This is the V. Yes. And there we are. Just pulling my yarn. And the next part is connected. Number 3 is connected to number 3. Now I'm going to take a very long piece of thread that's long enough to join the complete tube to the other tube. I'm going to cut a long piece of yarn and then we continue adding the pockets to the cardigan. To join this tube to the cardigan, I have to turn the cardigan towards me. Whoops. That makes it a lot easier to add one to another. Okay. Now we have to also add this part of the pocket to the cardigan. So I'm going to fold it to the inside. And now I'm going to join this tube to this tube. For that, I have my working yarn, a long working yarn, and I'm going to join the first 15 bars until I reach this part. So I'm going to join those two together. Just finding my first few stitches, and then I'm going to continue 2 by 2, just like we did before. Keep track and join the first bars. Now I'm at a point where my pocket begins or is joined at this piece. So I'm pulling through my yarn. And now I have to connect number 2. Make sure that you fold it correctly. Now you have to connect number 2. To number 2. So this will be connected. This is going to be your sleeve and then your pocket. And then you, when you have joined it completely, you start joining the rest. So now I'm going to change, instead of joining this one, I'm going to change to joining the back part of my pocket. I'm going to pick up the stitches from behind, so it's the ridge will be on the inside. I'm using the V-stitches, but it's upside down now. So, and then also alternating one bar per V with 2 bars per V. 2. Next V, 1 bar, next V, 2 bars, and when this piece is also connected, you continue. Joining the rest of the panel, but not all the way, because we have to connect the pocket also to this part. For that, you count 34 and 15 bars is 34 to 39, 49. You count 49 bars, and that's where you are going to join the second pocket. But before that, I'm going to join this. I see you back in a few moments. I'm going to join the back of my cardigan. The fun part is that I just advised you to count 49 or 50 stitches, but it's not necessary because you will find your next connecting point automatically, because that's how it goes. So I just go continue joining the last piece of my pocket, number four to number four. So I leave this and I'm going to join the V's to the bars. One bar, first V, two bars, second V, one bar. Dus you are going to alternate one bar with two bars until you have joined the complete pocket. Then we only have to finish off the last two pieces here. And then you have joined your pocket invisible. At the end, we are going to join and tuck away and knot those last pieces of yarn, but we do that at the end because then we can correct one and another tension part. You can cheat with your stitches, of course, so that you will end nice and correctly. Black is always complicated to watch, especially when doing a video. Going nice. And the last stitches of this pocket part. And now I have to join, this is my pocket, and now I have to join those two last pieces, and then I can continue with closing the pockets.
So
now I can take away those things and also on this side. I'm going to add another tube, so this will disappear. But first, I'm going to close the sides of the pockets just by doing what we did all the way. I'm going to start at the top, and then I'm going to join them to the bottom, just like I did with all the tubes. I have my piece of yarn and I'm just going to start closing the tube, finding the first bar and the bar on the opposite side. Leave the tails, we are finishing them at the end, and then just continue doing what we did all the way. Pick up those bars, 2 by 2, until you reach the end of this side of your pocket. So you have to do that for all your pockets on both sides. But we have done this so much now that you can figure out yourself how to do that. And then I'm going to add another or maybe two more tubes for the length. And then I see you back so I can explain how you can knit and add the border all the way around so that you have a nice finishing off. But first I have to close my pockets and add more tubes for the length. So I will meet you back when I have done that. I'm so happy with this cardigan. It's going to be so comfortable this winter. So, this one is closed. Just leave the tails. We are going to finish off that later and continue with joining the other sides of your pockets and adding tubes if you like. And I will meet you back for the border. So let's continue.
I've added my tubes and my cardigan is long enough. So now I'm going to add my border.
I'm getting a lot of questions about how long you have to knit the border for your cardigan using different machines and different sizes of tubes. It is very simple. I will explain. I'm demonstrating it on the baby vest because that's the smallest for in my view. So we made the vest out of tubes, so you can use all sizes of tubes, and I'm going to explain those tubes. You are going to join, this is knitted like this, and you are going to join like this. So I have calculated for each tube how many rows you have to knit, and I'm going to demonstrate how to calculate that. You can add all sizes of tubes to a border. So this is a drawing of my vest looking at this part. The tubes are the tubes. For the vest I draw, I use different tubes from different machines. This one is a new one. I don't have it yet, but I have seen a circular knitting machine with 32 needles. So you're looking now at the cardigan, and these are the tubes you are looking at. This is one tube, but you have to count them twice because the border will pass it two times. Okay. When you are joining a tube that's knitted like this to this, you need a certain number of rows to knit. Okay. When you have a tube with 22 stitches, you have to knit 17 rows. This is going that way. But that's only this part, but it also has to join this part because it's just one long tube. So I also have to knit 17 rows to join a 22 needle tube. So I'm joining the border like this. So this is needed amount of rows you have to knit for 17 rows. Do you have a cardigan with only 22 needle machine tubes? You have to knit 70 rows for every tube. So this 17 rows, 17 rows, 17 rows, 17 rows. But when you have a 32 needle machine, you have to knit for joining one tube 24 rows. So you have to knit 24 rows to join a tube with 32 stitches. The tube is going like this. And it's joining a tube like this. So I also have to knit 24 rows for the other ends. When you have a circular knitting machine that knits 40 stitches in the round, you have to knit 30 rows for your cardigan and also 30 rows for the opposite end. So I continue with the 44 needle machine, then you have to knit 32 rows. And for this 46 machine, you have to knit 34 rows. And for the biggest machine, the Centro with 48 needles, you have to knit, 36 rows. And you also have to do that for the opposite side, 36, 34, 32. That's, say you have only a adi, you have to knit for every tube two times 34 rows for your border. But we also have to knit the amount of stitches of rows for the neck. But the neck of your cardigan is also a tube. So in the pattern for the baby, you see you have 10 rows. And for the adult cardigan, you have 40 rows. That is the exact same amount of stitches you have to knit. So I will demonstrate it on the pattern. Look. See here, the number that's here, that's going to be the neck. That is the exact same number you have to knit for your cardigan, because that's exactly the same amount of rows. You are joining that like this. So how do you calculate how many rows you need for the border? You calculate for every tube two times the matching amount of rows you have to knit, and you have to count the amount of rows for the neck. That's 40 for the adult and 10 for the baby. You will always have a open space when joining the two arm pieces. That's going to be the neck, and that's always the same amount of rows you have to knit for the border. So all those stitches plus, say, 40, and then you have to just count 17 plus 24 plus 30 plus 32 plus 34 plus 36 plus 40 plus 36 plus 34. And then when you have calculated all those numbers, the final number is the amount of rows you have to knit for a border. And this is why the cat is doing what he's doing. He wants snacks. Okay, I hope that this was a good explanation for you, and that you will be fine following the workshop from now. Don't forget to count the amount of rows you have knitted for your neck in the pattern, because you are going to join it. Don't forget that. And for the rest, just count the amount of rows you need to knit to join whatever tube you have. So that's the extra explanation. Thank you. Have fun.
I'm counting for you the border for this cardigan, starting at the bottom and then going up, knitting the amount of rows matching my tubes. At the top, I also have to count the neck. And then I'm going down, counting the exact amount of numbers I used going up. So it's going up, the neck, and going down. And that's all the rows you have to knit for the border tube. And that's it. Not complicated. Use the list.
In this project, we are going to connect the border to our knitting like this. It's very simple to do that. You wish you knew this 10 years before. And I'm going to explain how this works. We have different sizes of tubes, and we are going to flatten them then and close them. So when you have a 22 needle tube, you will be having 11 stitches, those V stitches, in one row on the front. When you have knitted a 46 needle tube, you will have 23 stitches. I made a small chart to explain that. It's a very simple chart. You have to see this as tubes, so like this, and you want to join them to a tube like this. You're going to join them like this. So I draw them the way they are. Yes? So when you have a tube with 22 stitches in the round, when you flatten it, it will be having 11 V stitches. To connect those stitches to sideways to the tube, you need a tube with 17 rows. For connecting 11 stitches seamless, you need 17 rows. For a tube with 40 needles, 20 stitches flat, you need 30 rows in the long tube. So you can calculate by counting your tubes how many rows you need to knit for your border. Do you have a 44 needle machine? 22 stitches, you need to knit 32 rows to join the 22 stitches to. Do you have a 46 needle machine? You have to 23 stitches flat. You need to join them to 34 stitches. And the 48 needle machine, 24 stitches. When flat, you need to join them to 36 stitches. And how do we do that? Now, I will demonstrate that. We have our V stitches. I just pick some piece. We have our V stitches. So you find your V stitches.
These are all those V. This is a V, and this is a V, and there are 11 V's all the way. And we are going to connect them to vertical bars. We have our bars here in our work. This is a bar. These are the vertical bars. We are going to add our border with just one track with vertical bars. How are we going to do that? This is just an example piece. You pick up a V, and then you pick up one vertical bar. These are the V-stitches and these are the bars. So one V-stitch, one vertical bar. The second V-stitch, you pick up two vertical bars. See? First one, one vertical bar. Second one, two vertical bars. Then you go to your third V-stitch, just in the same row, and you are going to connect that to one vertical bar. And then we have our next V-stitch. We are going to connect that to two vertical bars. And then next V-stitch, one vertical bar. Next V-stitch, two vertical bars. Third stitch, and next stitch weer, one vertical bar. Next stitch, two, yes. You can smuggle, but basically, you just pull your yarn. And this is how it works. One V-stitch, one bar, second V-stitch, two bars, one bar, two bar. And you will see that it is the prettiest joining you have ever seen. So this is how that works. Let's continue. Now I'm going to add the border I've knitted to my cardigan, and I start at the bottom corner. When you are wearing it, it's the right bottom corner. You start there with picking up your first V. We are using this technique. One V, one bar, one V, two bars, one V, one bar, one V, two bars, so. All the way up. So I'm finding my first V. And I have my yarn still. I did not cut it because I need a very long piece. And now I always have enough. So I've picked up my first V. I'm taking my panel, my border, and I'm putting it to the inside. The short side to the bottom. And then I'm going to join, as we did before, each V with one or two bars all the way up. And when you're up, dum-ti-dum-ti-dum-ti-dum-ti-dum, just continue doing, and when you are at the neck, this is a corner, you just continue by adding the border, and then you just add 2x2 bars until you reach your next corner, and you go all the way down by doing V-stitch with bars connecting And then you're almost finished. You only have to cast off all those pieces. They're not a lot, about 12 or something. And I have to join the sleeves, the border. So I see you back when I have joined my complete border to my cardigan. And our next step is finishing off all those yarn ends. I just put an end on the inside of my cardigan into my needle. There are little holes at the corners, and you just stick your needle through the layer on the inside. It's double layered, and through all three pieces, so that they are closed on the inside. Make sure you don't go through both layers. And then you just simply make a half knot around your needle and pull through your yarn. Now it's secured. And then you can just put your yarn needle with the yarn between the two layers and let it come out somewhere else. And it's disappeared, and you can cut it. And then, ta-da, it's gone. And you are going to do that with all those ends. At the pockets, there is not a real piece you have to join. So you can just make a half knot, oops, around your needle. And it's secured. And you can just put your yarn between two layers and you're finished. So continue with finishing off all the yarn ends, and then I will see you again to join the sleeves if they are a bit too long, how you can join that nice and neat. So continue, and then we're almost finished. I'm going to finish off my sleeve now. I'm going to fold it, and I'm using the longest piece of yarn from the two ends I have here. And I'm going to demonstrate to you what I'm going to do. I'm going to join my V-stitches, the upper one, to the upside down V stitch above. So this is a upside down V stitch. So I'm just going to join those gray V's with the black A's, the upside down V's. And I'm going to do that all the way around. You can just easily pull on your piece of yarn and it will close nice. So I'm going to continue. And you just continue all the way around, and then your sleeve is nice, finished, seamless closed. So if you like this tutorial and would like to see my other tutorials, join my channel. And if you like my video,
please give me a thumb up. I have also a Facebook group, Instagram. You will see everything in the description of this video. Also the link to my other circular knitting machine videos. I hope you like your cardigan and I wish you a warm winter. Bye bye. Thank you for watching. See you next time with love from Holland.
And the bonus for the baby cardigan follows after these pictures about making the baby cardigan. So in a moment I will continue with demonstrating the pattern for the baby cardigan bonus.
And the bonus at the end of the video is the pattern for these lovely baby cardigans. It's very simple to create. You can use your 22 needle circular knitting machine. For the upper part, you need that. And for the rest, you can use your 22 needle circular knitting machine. But you can also use other sizes of circular knitting machines. And the pattern is basically like this. Knitted with your 22 needle circular knitting machine is this part. 2x40 rows for the front parts of the sleeves and 1x90 rows for the back parts of the sleeves and the back of the baby. And then you can add tubes for the length and they are 17 rows. Here I knitted 3 tubes of 17 rows with a 22 needle circular knitting machine. And here I knitted 1 tube with a 46 stitches circular knitting machine. So you can combine them. And then of course you have to count for your border all your rows you need to knit for your borders depending on the panels. So this is basically how you create smaller baby or smaller children cardigans, and you can adjust the amount of stitch of rows, of course. But first we have the adult cardigan and the baby cardigan, and in between, yes, just knit a cardigan and find a person who likes it and who fits. So thank you for watching and stay safe with love from Holland, and have a nice and warm winter. Bye bye, and thank you for watching.